defenses have to go.
What up, Division 2 players, and this is Tips and Tricks for Division 2, and I am bringing you a Bleed Explosive Predmark 2.0 Explosive Damage. Oh my god, Explosive translates to Bleeding Damage, which is a good thing, guys. As long as it's not towards your friends. And let's get this started. We've got a pretty cool thing. You do need to equip your signature weapon, that's Demolitionist, for that 30% opt-out explosive damage that you have to do for this build. And we've got Sadist on the gun, that 22.3k, don't worry about that, it's really low. I'm all up at the high weapon damage, but check this out. Sadist gives you deal 30% weapon damage to bleeding enemies after 3 kills, apply bleed to the next enemy you hit. So, that 30% right there, that is crazy. And this Wicked Gloves here is giving me another 15%. So that is going to translate to a number of 32.33 damage, okay? That's the real damage. So the base damage is 22.3. But the real damage from the talents all together is 32.33, all right? So the Merciless here is going to give you another 100% explosive damage. Brutality, that's a talent. While holstered, landing a shot has a 5% chance to deal 100% damage as explosive damage. And this is modded out, don't need to show you anything else. The handgun, we're here for this. Stop, drop, and roll. While equipped, rolling removes burning and bleeding poison status effects. Can occur once every 60 seconds. And my friend told me, hey, what do you mod your gun out as? So just mod your guns out with everything, all right? That's damaging to the NPC. So I got 8% damage with elites, hollow sight, 6% damage with elites, muzzle, and a 5% critical hit to the handrail. All right, so let's go on to the gear set now, guys. Creeping Death, I got a China Light Industries, 10% explosive damage on top, 461 skill power, don't worry about the health. Creeping Death is what we want. It is the awesome thing that spreads the bleed, the burn, the explosive. So status effects spreads to the nearest enemy within 25 meters, can occur once every 5 seconds. Woo, it's good, guys. The only downfall, 4 or less, okay? You can't have any more. That's why my weapon damage would be so high, I wasn't prohibited to have it more than 4. So that's why this, but this is still good. This is amazing, all right? So the backpack, I got 40% explosive damage with a 10% weapon damage there. It's a Gilligard offensive mod there of 6.5, 1% damage to health, a health mod in there of 10,000 health, bleed resistance, disruption resistance, 77%. And we've got a chess piece of Murakami Industries, Unbreakable. All right, Unbreakable is awesome. The only way you practice is 11 blues, guys. So this is a god roll for me, guys. I got this, I don't know where, but I did get it before the targeted loot. So it's 13.5 total armor and 17,623 armor. And that 1,019 skill power, I rolled that, recalibrated over that, and this is what I got. So, okay, we've got a utility mod of a 4.5 explosive damage, 67 skill power, 2% burn damage. And we've got a 9 armor mod there. And we've got a holster here, Ferris Group, 10% assault rifle. That will not proc. No, actually, that does proc. I'm so sorry. And I've got 813 skill power. And this is pretty good here. If you can't put any more reds, right, devastating will give you a 5% weapon damage. So right off the bat, you're going to get that. So if you can't get any more reds on this. Moving on to the knee pads, we've got a 7% damage from leads, Badger Tough. It will always give you 2 blues. And we've got a weapon mod here of 6% and a 1% damage to health. And the gloves, of course, you already know. But I've got a Gilligard of total armor and hazard protection. And a 13% that I recalibrate over this assault rifle damage. And Wicked is great. When you apply a status effect, gain 15% weapon damage for 20 seconds. It's giving me literally this right here, 30% weapon damage. And 15% weapon damage is giving this total of 22.3, those crazy imaginary numbers, 32.33. All right. So let's go to the toys now.
Okay.
So this here is the gear set. Okay, guys, this is what I'm working with. And for the Hive, the Pistol of the Resistance, Stinger Hive, it gives you bleed, bleed, bleed. Oh my God, it's awesome, guys. See that? Applies bleed status effect on affected target. So I'm hitting pretty much 63,166 per charge. The charge are the stingers that go out of this stinger hive. Okay, so I got 8 of them. And they refill for you faster if you have skill haste on here. So I've got a 74.2 skill haste, and I've got a battery of 307 and a radius of 83. I wish that was a 99. That would have been awesome. But I'll show you, the radius is pretty damn big. Even as at 83%, it's still darn big. And this will give you a bleed.
Bleed.
And we've got a Seeker Vine here that's doing the same explosive bleed damage. All right, so that 100% explosive damage from my Merciless is translating to this too. And all the mods and all the gear I have is translating to this damage here. That's why the damage is so high. 303,006 damage because of all the mods and all the explosive stuff I have gathered up from all my guns and gear, okay? This is what the number is giving me right there. And of course, each mine is carrying that 300,003 each per mine that's going out. And the cooldown is 16 seconds. And of course, I got 2 skill haste there, 113 skill haste, 152 skill haste, and a battery pack of 291. And
reinforcements incoming. Detecting additional hostile contacts.
100. Let's go to the stats, guys. Here we go. I know this is going to be cuckoo. Hold on. 30% critical damage. I got a 55% headshot damage. And I know this is going to be low. So we've got a 16.5% all weapon damage bonus and a 49% assault rifle damage bonus. That will give me only 65 assault rifle damage. That ain't bad at all. Pretty bad on math. Okay, so damage release is 20%. No big deal. We're not there for this. We're not doing a raid build, all right? We're doing a skill bleed build, which you can use, but I would say not to. This is all for your heroic missions and team builds, all right? And we've got here. This is what we're here for, guys. So I have Merciless giving me 100% explosive damage, and this right here with all my mods and all my gear. So I got 84.5% explosive damage. So that's 184.5 explosive damage. So explosive translates to bleed. Bleed is always good for you against the NPC. And that's my build, guys. I hope you put this together, you know, have some fun with it. I'm just putting this out there for fun. I've got an Eagle Bear high weapon damage build and a Pyromaniac that I already put out. So, you know, work on these builds, have fun with it, make it your own, and yo, one love, y'all. You know who you are. Mad props to everybody that's been supporting me, and I'm still as sick as a dog. And happy holidays and happy Hanukkah. Let me demonstrate to you guys how big the radius is for this. It's pretty cool, and this is how you go into warfare with this. So I'd run over here, boom. See how clearly how big that is, man. Holy crap. It's huge, guys. And you drop that there. You throw out your seeker mine. Boom, boom, boom. And you murder the crap out of all these NPCs, man. It's pretty awesome. And I forget to tell you, man. And you're done. If you can pick this up. Right back up. It's pretty cool, right? And then pretty much move on to the next thing. And I like to do this sometimes. If the ads are right here, I run right past them, drop this shit, go to cover, shoot them. That's what you did, yo. That's how this build is made for. It's very sneaky, it's very sly, it's a lot of fun, and that's how I built this to be. And you can pick it up right again and use it right away, yo. It's awesome. All right, y'all. Hope to help you out. Next. Thank you.